Hello engineers, this is one PC user, and in last AutoCAD tutorial I talked about how to use this polyline command. And we are humans, so we normally make mistakes, so I think you might make mistakes while using polyline commands. So today I decided to make video about how to edit polyline, how to make some changes in polyline and fix our errors. So without wasting time, let's get started. Let's draw one polyline here. Now I want to edit this polyline. So there are basically two ways to edit this polyline. You can open tools to open this edit this polyline by double clicking on this polyline. As you can see here, now it is showing here some options to edit this polyline. And there is one another way to edit this polyline. You can click on this modify tool and then click on this edit polyline and then select object. Now you can see your options to edit this polyline. And third way is simply write here EE in command line. As you can see here, now you can see your options to edit polyline. Now select your object. Now you can see here all the options to edit polyline. So first one is close. Actually this object is already closed, so I cannot use here close, and I have not any other object to join with this, so I can't use here join, but I can use here width. So I will show you how to change width of these polylines. So I will simply click on width. Now it is asking to specify new width for all segment. So what should be the width? No, this is too much. I think this is enough. Now as you can see here, it has edited its width. Now third one is edit vertex. Actually I will explain it later. First I will explain I done some mistakes. So let control Z. Let's explain now. I will edit it by double clicking on it. I have already explained about width. Now I will explain about feet. If I will click on feet, then it will convert it into some of these curved lines, some of arcs. And if I don't want this curved shape, then I will click on decurve. So now we have our original object, and if you want it to convert it into curved shape, then you can click on fit, but I don't want it right now, so I will click on decurve. And you can also convert it in splines. Then this is reverse. I have to explain it with another object. Let me close it for now. I will delete this one. I will select here line command and draw here M. As you can see here, this is our first point, this is our second point, this is our third point, this is our fourth point, and this is our fifth point. And if I will edit here and click on reverse, then this will become our first point, and this one will become second point, third point, fourth point, and fifth point. So I think now you understand what is the application of this reverse command. Then this is LT type gen. I don't use it normally. And now I will talk about join and close. Let's click on close. As you can see here, it just joined this object. So this is the application of close. And now I will explain how to use join, how to join two polylines. And make sure that which two polyline you want to join, that should not be closed. As you can see here, this polyline is not closed. And if you will try to join to close the polyline, then it might not work. So because of that reason, keep that in your mind. Let's draw here another polyline. So now I will join this. First I will edit it by double clicking on it. Now I will click on join and then select this object and this object. Now I will simply press enter. Now let me show you, these two objects are selected. As you can see, these two objects are joined. So this is how we use join command for polyline, how to join this polyline. Now I am going to explain about vertex. For that I have to draw another object. I will use here polyline. I have to use here arc. And then line again. So now I am going to use here edit vertex. And when I click on edit vertex, you will see here cross the marks. You can also call it X. Actually, whatever change you will do here, that all the change will appear on this particular area. Because of that reason, it is showing here this cross mark. And if you don't want to make any change here, you want to make change here, then you can just move it like this, next, previous, right it. And if you think you have made here mistake, you don't want to close this object from here, then you can break it like this. Now I have to go to previous. Now go. As you can see here, this object is breaked. Now next one is insert. Let's click on insert. Now I want to add here one object, so I will simply join this. As you can see here, it added here another SP line, polyline. And now if you want to move this, then you can also move it. Let's click on move. And then I will select here this point. Enter. Let me explain it again, because I think I have not explained it properly. This is our object. Let's edit it. Now I will use your edit vertex. This is our first point and I am going to move it from here. Enter. And if I want, then I can also specify another location if I want to move. I think I have to explain it again. I will select here move again. And then I will select here this point. As you can see here, it has moved up from this point to this point. This is how it works. And region, actually this is region return command. And if we have to use it when it doesn't appear properly quickly. And I don't think I have to explain this command. And the next one is straighten. Actually we use this command when we don't want here arcs, we want only straight lines, then we can use here that command. Let me show you. I will click on next. For example, I don't want this curved shape, I want here straight line instead of curved shape. Then I will use here straighten. Then I will click on next, then go. As you can see here, now I have straight line instead of that curve. So this is how you can remove that curve and add here straight line. And then next one is tangent. Let me show you. Before I use here, I think I have to convert it into feet. Now I am going to choose here edit vertex, tangent. I will give your tangent in this direction. Enter. I will give you a direction again. This is the direction. What actually happened? Let me explain. Actually, if I am not wrong, then I have gave direction in this direction. Let me use here again line command. In this direction. And because of this reason, all this curve become tangent to this line. As you can see, it is tangent to this line. So I think now you know how to edit this polyline command. And I think I have forget to tell you something, so I think I have to explain it again. I will click on edit vertex because I have explained all of this. Then next one is width. If I will click on width, then it is showing here width from starting width to next segment, and starting width is 0. Let's make it 1, enter, and then next width will be 3, enter. As you can see here, it changed its width like this to the this particular vertex, this particular point, because this point was marked by X. So I think you know how to use this, how to edit our polyline command. Now you can get lost.